So what's happening tonight here in Palm Springs is Marriage Equality is having a rally, as they are across the country. So we are here today in a peaceful way to make our voices heard about, everybody wants to express their emotions about what's happening. I think the younger generation is very angry at what happened. I think the other people who have been through this before are looking at how much we've accomplished and where we should go from here.
Now, this is going to be on the ballot again next year, correct?
We're going to try to get it on the ballot in 2010 or 2012. We're not sure.
Okay, hopefully 2010. If anybody wants any more information, do you have a website that someone go to keep up on what's going on?
You can go to marriageequality.com and look up your states, and it has all the information of what's going on with it.
Now, you personally, when you heard the news today, how did you react? Did you expect it?
Unfortunately, I did sort of expect it just because the way things have gone here in the state. I was very upset by it. My partner and I have 21 years, were married last summer in San Francisco, and we'd kind of hoped that our friends would be able to do the same, and now that's on hold for them.
Now, how do you guys put together an event like this, and how do you, I mean, at such short notice, because the announcement was made today at 10 o'clock in the morning, and now it's 7 o'clock at night, how do you get these people here?
Well, the coalition has been meeting ever since Prop 8 passed, and we did an event the day of the kickoff when it went to the trial, and now we've done this event. It's mostly done by email and telephone calls.
So basically just word of mouth and people just spread the word?
Correct. Everybody is mailing to everybody's list and to everybody's list and to everybody's list. When we knew that the announcement would probably come today, we forewarned people that we would confirm it this morning, and we did.
Now, if anybody wants any information on your local, I guess, chapter, do you have a website?
There is a desertnohate.org, and they can go there and all the information is there.
First of all, I'd like to thank you all for coming out tonight. The news we received today was not the news any of us wanted to hear.
City's responsibility. This is the county, so I just want you to know that. When we demonstrated across the street a year ago, we didn't have water raining on our parade. We had joy in our heart, and it was a wonderful feeling a year ago. And here, and I think all of you know me, I'm never at a loss for words. I'm at a loss for words tonight. Because it is something that I was kind of expecting was going to happen, but I kept saying to myself, not in California. This is not going to happen in California. They're not going to take our rights away in California. They're not going to vote against marriage between my partner and myself in California. They're not going to vote against the people who want to have partnership together, want to spend their life together, want to have their children be in a same situation in their school as other children. They're not going to vote against that, but they did. And they did it, and I ask myself, did we lose the battle or did they win the battle? And I've got to say to myself that I think we lost that particular battle because we weren't strong enough. We became complacent. We live in this city where things are okay for us. We can walk down the street and hold hands, and we can be together. But when you leave this community, it's not the same. Riverside County overwhelmingly voted for Prop 8. And so we did lose, and we lost because of our own complacency. We lost because we didn't get involved in the battles. We lost because we decided that maybe we should have somebody else run a campaign for us and not do the grassroots campaign that's always been so successful for us. And so now we're going to do something else. And we're going to put it back on the agenda.
What a great turnout tonight. A night that we were hoping to celebrate. Yet a night when we were told by our Supreme Court that we are second-class citizens.
All right.
All of us standing here tonight should say a resounding no to that statement.
No.
Hell no.
We should tell them no, we are not second-class citizens. We should tell them that today marks the first day in our final march to equality for all of us.
Yeah.